Have you ever wondered what sets us apart from our ancient relatives? Or what makes us Homo sapiens and not Neanderthals? If you have, then you know the Neanderthal versus Homo sapiens argument could go on for generations to come without a definite answer. And this video just adds another one to the collection. Everyone on the planet today, whatever they look like or wherever they live, is classified by biologists in the species Homo sapiens. But some commentators are now suggesting that the extinct Neanderthals with their heavy brows and big noses should be classified in our species as well. Before we come to this though, let us first take a look at the differences between them. In the Chronicles of Ancient History, two prominent chapters are penned by Homo sapiens and Neanderthals. These two distinct human branches traversed parallel pathways across time, with each contributing their unique attributes and idiosyncrasies. The contrast between these ancient kinfolk unveils a saga of both commonalities and disparities, an interplay that has profoundly influenced our understanding of human evolution. Homo sapiens and Neanderthals, while sharing certain traits, exhibited notable physical differences. Neanderthals adapted to colder climates, featured robust frames, shorter limbs, and pronounced brow ridges. Their cranial structure was distinct, mirroring their adaptation. In contrast, Homo sapiens presented a more graceful build, greater height, and a cranial form marked by a smoother contour, adaptability to diverse habitats. Even the three tiny bones of our middle ear, vital in hearing, can be readily distinguished from those of Neanderthals with careful measurement. In fact, the shape differences in the ear bones are more marked on average than those that distinguish our closest living relatives, chimpanzees and gorillas, from each other. The shape of their teeth provides scientists with the clearest picture of Neanderthal life. According to scientists, Neanderthal teeth developed much earlier than those of Homo sapiens, and they grew faster than human teeth. Neanderthals' teeth were also much bigger when compared to Homo sapiens, with larger roots, large gaps after the molar, and larger pulp cavities. Our next discussion is speech. It has long been speculated whether Neanderthals spoke and whether they communicated using language. However, research indicates that they could speak and communicate using language. According to the same line of research, their speech ability can be deduced from the amount of space at the skull base and the vocal tract structure. Scientists found that the base of Neanderthal skulls were less arched than humans, but yet more arched than chimpanzees, which suggests they were able to produce speech. However, the speech may not be in the same sound range or as diverse as Homo sapiens. An intriguing aspect of both groups was their capacity for culture. Neanderthals displayed cultural expressions through tools, symbolic ornaments, and possibly even rudimentary art. This suggests cognitive complexity and an inclination for symbolism. Homo sapiens, however, showcased a broader range of artistic manifestations, including intricate cave art and symbolic artifacts, indicating a higher level of cognitive and creative development. Both Homo sapiens and Neanderthals exhibited social inclinations. Neanderthal communities likely lived in smaller groups to optimize resource usage in their challenging environments. Archaeological evidence hints at care for the infirm, implying a rudimentary form of empathy and societal structure. Homo sapiens formed similar small groups but demonstrated more intricate social networks facilitated by advanced communication and symbolic language. Coming to technological progress, it marked a significant aspect of both lineages. Neanderthals innovated tools attuned to their surroundings, crafting implements specialized for hunting and woodworking. Homo sapiens, however, displayed enhanced tool-making skills and adaptability, forging intricate tools that suited diverse environments. Diet also played a pivotal role in shaping the physiology of these hominins. Neanderthals subsisted on a diet of meat and plants tailored to their cold-adapted physique. Homo sapiens, inhabiting a wider geographical range, embraced more varied diets, incorporating a spectrum of plant resources and refining cooking techniques. Cooking not only rendered food more digestible, but also potentially facilitated brain expansion. Lastly, we have interactions and genetic legacy. As the epochs intersected, evidence emerged of interactions between Homo sapiens and Neanderthals. Genetic analysis revealed traces of Neanderthal DNA in modern non-African populations, indicating instances of interbreeding. This genetic legacy underscores the intricate web woven between these ancient human branches. Now, coming to the question if Neanderthals should be classified in our species as well. We all know that modern humans and Neanderthals interbred. For some, that may not be such a big deal, but to some, they think it is so important, so much so that because they interbred, they say that they belong to the same species. So, critics who disagree that Homo neanderthalensis and Homo sapiens are two separate species can now cite supporting from recent genetic research. This indicates that the two interbred with each other when they met outside Africa about 55,000 years ago. As a result, everyone today whose ancestors lived outside Africa at that time has inherited a small but significant amount of Neanderthal DNA, which makes up to about 2% of their genomes. Many still believe they belong to different species, though. We now know from the same kind of genomic research that many other species of mammals interbred with each other. For example, different kinds of baboons, wolves and wild dogs, bears and large cats. In addition, one recent estimate suggests that at least 16% of all bird species interbreed with each other in the wild, and that does not make them the same species. Thus, the problem is not with Neanderthals and modern humans and all the other species that interbreed with each other, but with the biological species concept itself. Neanderthals and Homo sapiens remained separate long enough to evolve such distinctive skull shapes, pelvises, and ear bones, and they can be regarded as different species, interbreeding or not. And with that, we have come to the end of the video. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Do tell us what you think of it in the comment section down below. And before you go, please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.